For the life of me, I never understood why people like attending these festivals. Burning Man. This was last year when thousands of people were trapped in the Nevada desert in mud because of rain. And don't even get me started on the fire festival that Billy McFarlane and Ja Rule did when they made people stay out there with no food, no nothing, no hotels, nothing that they were selling basically on this festival, right? He owed $26 million the last time I checked, and allegedly, as of now, he's only paid back $30,000, and he's constantly in court for all kinds of bullshit. So these people that run these festivals, most of them are scam artists. Obviously, the bigger festivals, those are huge mega groups that are putting these festivals on. It's never been something that's, I've never been interested in this. Even when I was growing up in the 90s, I had friends that went to things like Freaknik. I've had people call me and say, let's go to Lollapalooza. I've just never, it's never intrigued me to be around a lot of dirty, nasty people with communicable diseases. And God knows what goes on at these festivals. But this year, they're saying that they're having issues selling these tickets for Coachella. Now, you guys know Coachella is one of the most popular music festivals, and young people flock to this every year. They're blaming the headliners that they chose for the low ticket sales. Can you imagine? People like Doja Cat is a headliner this year. Tyler, the Creator. My daughter has even gone to his concerts and said he's actually very slow and doesn't show up. He's kind of like taking after Madonna, you know, just shows up on stage when he wants to. Lana Del Rey, who I seem to have no issues with, but really, you're going to blame people like headlining Lana Del Rey? And somebody from my generation, No Doubt. Let's say No Doubt is going to show up. You think Gen Xers and millennials are going to go pay to see No Doubt? Sure, Gwen Stefani hasn't had a show in probably 10 years or more, but people don't have money. That's the real reason they're not going to these festivals. Coachella seems like they need to get their shit together. Whoever is planning and organizing this event says that the ticket sales have gone up. Yes, obviously due to inflation, you know, they got to make more money. It went up from $399 to $499 since 2017. What? Like, people can't even afford this. The real reason people are not buying these tickets, I hope Coachella organizers are listening, is because not everyone is rich. You guys are creating such a disparity between the upper echelon class, the celebrities, your actors, these people, and rich billionaires, to the poor people. There is no middle class to buy these tickets anymore. I hope people understand this. If you get rid of the middle class, who are the people that can afford these tickets, you're just not going to have anyone showing up other than your celebrities and your posh, you know, superstar. So I don't know what they're thinking here. It's just a matter of you are creating a disparity between the rich and the poor, and people genuinely cannot afford these tickets anymore. People that do afford these tickets, you know, hopefully you get what you deserve, because spending a lot of money just to fit in, just to be on the bandwagon think, is very scary. It's a scary time we're living in. There's a fear of missing out, I think, amongst young people. And that's the only reason they go to these type of events. Just pay to go to a bloody concert and get a concert where people actually show up on time and perform on time. But they need to stop with this and blaming it on the headliners. It's not the headliners. No, no. It's y'all thinking that people can pay more. What you should have done was lower the prices this year. Lower the prices. Have a great day. Think for yourself.